Good morning.
Good morning.
And welcome to worship today. And welcome to those who are joining us online. As we gather, and we will hear God's word read and proclaimed. And we have the great honor and privilege to return to God our prayers and our praises and to receive the great gift of our Lord's body and blood. Some announcements. Lent starts on Wednesday, Ash Wednesday service. And our services are going to be at 7 p.m., not 7:30, okay? 7 p.m. It says 7:30 on the calendar, but, you know, we can always change something. There we go. And this year, we are going to be taking a journey with Jonah, the prophet Jonah. And so I'm excited about that. So we got birthday bags to put together today. There is at least 120 of them there. So we need help, you know. It's all in order. Just kind of pick them up and put them together, and we got to staple them and those kinds of things. If you would turn to page 9 in your bulletin. This is just the easiest way for me to do this. I don't know if you heard of the young woman, the young mother who recently passed away from breast cancer and left, of course, her husband and three children. One child is just a year old. She was diagnosed right after she gave birth. That is what's here, this family, that the service group is put out $300, and they ask us to maybe match that or do more. And as you'll read there, this is one of the gentlemen that cleans our parking lot for us. So I invite you to do that. You can write on your check or however you want to indicate that for that family. So another opportunity for us to reach out to those in our community who are in need. That is the announcements that I have. Are there any from members of the congregation? If not, then let us prepare our hearts for worship. I invite you to stand as you're able as we begin our worship with the order of confession and forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, love from above, word made flesh, breath of heaven. Let us confess our sins before God and one another, trusting in God's endless mercy and love. Merciful God, we confess that we are not perfect. We have said and done things we regret. We have tried to earn your redeeming grace while denying it to others. We have resisted your call to your voice in the world. Forgive us, loving God. Give us your righteousness, the strength to overcome our failures, and the courage to try again. Amen. Dear people of God, hear the good news. Christ the Savior is born. You are loved and forgiven in the name of Jesus, who has come among us. You are free from proving that you deserve to be loved, because God's love is given to you as the most precious gift of all. Rejoice in this love and share it with the world. Amen. Our gathering hymn. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Save and defend us, O God.
And together we pray. O God, in the transfiguration of your Son, you confirmed the mysteries of the faith by the witnesses of Moses and Elijah, and in the voice from the bright cloud, declaring Jesus your beloved Son. You foreshadowed our adoption as your children, making us heirs with Christ in your glory, and bring us to enjoy its fullness. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated and continue with the reading of the Word.
Good morning.
Good morning.
The first reading for today, which speaks to the transfiguration of our Lord, is from Exodus chapter 24, verses 12 through 18. The Lord said to Moses, "Come up to me on the mountain and wait there, and I will give you the tablets of stone with the law and the commandment which I have written for their instruction." So Moses set out with his assistant Joshua, and Moses went up into the mountain of God. To the elders he had said, "Wait here for us until we come to you again, for Aaron and Hur are with you. Whoever has a dispute may go to them." Then Moses went up on the mountain, and the cloud covered the mountain. The glory of the Lord settled on Mount Sinai, and the cloud covered it for 6 days. On the seventh day, he called to Moses out of the cloud. Now the appearance of the glory of the Lord was like a devouring fire on the top of the mountain, in the sight of the people of Israel. Moses entered the cloud and went up on the mountain. Moses was on the mountain for 40 days and 40 nights. This is the word of the Lord. The psalm for today, which we'll read responsively, is Psalm 2. Why are the nations in an uproar? Why do peoples mutter empty threats? Why do the kings of the earth rise up in revolt, and the princes plot together against the Lord and against the Lord's anointed? Let us break their yoke, they say. Let us cast off their bonds from us. God, whose throne is in heaven, is laughing. The Lord holds them in derision. Then in wrath, God speaks to them, and in rage, fills them with terror. As for me, I have anointed my king upon Zion, my holy mountain. Let me announce the decree of the Lord, who said to me, "You are my son. This day I have I begotten you. Ask of me, and I will give you the nations for your inheritance, and the ends of the earth for your possession. You shall crush them with an iron rod and shatter them like a piece of pottery. And now, you kings, be wise, be warned, you rulers of the earth. Submit to the Lord with fear and with trembling bow in worship, lest the Lord be angry and you perish in a sudden blaze of wrath. Happy are all who take refuge in God." The second reading for today is from 2 Peter chapter 1, verses 16 through 21. "For we did not follow cleverly devised myths when we made known to you the power and coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, but we had been eyewitnesses of his majesty. For he received honor and glory from God the Father when that voice was conveyed to him by the majestic glory, saying, 'This is my Son, my beloved, with whom I am well pleased.' We ourselves heard this voice come from heaven while we were with him on the holy mountain. So we have the prophetic message more fully confirmed. You will do well to be attentive to this, as to a lamp shining in a dark place, until the day dawns and the morning star rises in your heart. First of all, you must understand this, that no prophecy of Scripture is a matter of one's own interpretation, because no prophecy ever came by human will, but by men and women moved by the Holy Spirit spoke from God. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
I invite the children to join me if they'd like.
Excuse me, Porter, excuse me. Excuse me, excuse me, excuse me.
Okay, everyone sit down here. Okay, we got a few things to put up here. I'm going to keep this. Okay, somebody want to put this one up? Somebody want to put this one up? Here, you want to? Here. Okay. Here's another one for you. Here you go, Harper. Here you go, Isla. Did you want to put one up, Porter? Here. Just stick it up there. Stick it up there someplace. Perfect. Everything's perfect. Woohoo! I like this. I like this. Okay, so I got a question for you. Do you have rules at home? Do you have rules that you need to follow at home? Do you? What? Like what? What are some of the rules at home? Do you have rules about not fighting? Not teasing? Do you have rules like that? Do you have rules about sitting and eating your supper and your dinner? Do you have to clean that up? Do you have to eat right, all the things that your parents did for you? Do you have rules about picking up your clothes, putting them in the laundry? Do you have rules like that at your house? I'm sure you do. I'm sure you do. If not, your parents had just been suggested. So, do you have rules at school? Do you have rules at school or daycare? What are some of the rules at school that you have to follow? What? No running in the halls. What other rules do you have at school? What rules do you have at school, Carson? Huh? What rules do you have at school? What do you have? What rule do you have at school? Pretty lenient school you go to there. Well, I'm sure you have all kinds of rules. I want to tell you a story today about how God gave rules. And what God called them was commandments. And these rules, these commandments, were about helping us all to live together in harmony, being kind to one another and to parents and everybody. Okay. There was a guy, his name was Moses, and this was a long time ago. And God said to Moses, come up on the mountain. Come up on this tall, tall mountain. So Moses climbed the mountain. And while he was up there, a big cloud came and covered everything. It was bigger than that. And God talked to Moses up there. And God said, Moses, here are some rules so that the people can live together, because there were thousands of people, and they weren't living together very well. And so God gave Moses, and those were on stone tablets, the commandments. We call the commandments, and there's 10 of them. And some of them are like, don't say bad things about God. Others are, come to church and wham, and things like that. Others are, be nice to your parents. Others are, don't say bad things about other people. And others are, don't take other people's things. And there's many more. And God gave those rules so that we could live together in harmony. Just like we have rules at home, so there's some order to it. You have rules at school, so people don't get hurt running in the halls, right? Yes, there's rules. So God gave us these because God wants us all to live together in harmony, to be kind to one another, to not say bad things about other people, to be nice to our parents, to come to church and wham, and those things. All of that is because God loves us and wants good things for us. Wants us all to live together and harmony. And these rules aren't just for kids. These rules are for adults too, okay? So they know that, and they have to work on following the rules too, okay? So it's not just kids that have rules. Adults have rules too from God, okay? Let's pray. We thank you, Lord, that you've given us these rules to live together, that we can be kind to one another, that we can be with you, that we cannot say bad things about people. Help us remember these rules, that we can just live together in harmony. Thank you for each one of these children and for the gift that they are. May you bless them and keep them safe in all that they say and do and wherever they might go. In your precious and holy name we pray. And everybody says, amen. You want one of these to color? Here, grab one. They're all the same. They're all exactly the same. Honest. They're all the same. Okay. And remember, if you color them and you bring them to me, we hang them up on a door. We got to find some more doors to hang things on. I invite you to stand as you're able for our gospel acclamation.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Now, like you really mean.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
It is with great sadness that I tell you we won't be singing that again till Easter. You think it's funny, don't you? But we will be bringing it back, so. Okay. Our holy gospel for this day comes from the 17th chapter of the gospel according to St. Matthew. Jesus took with him Peter and James and his brother John and led them up a high mountain by themselves. And he was transfigured before them, and his face shone like sun, and his clothes became dazzling white. Suddenly there appeared to them Moses and Elijah talking with him. Then Peter said to Jesus, Lord, is it good for us to be here? If you wish, I will make three dwellings here, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah. While he was still speaking, suddenly a bright cloud overshadowed them, and from the cloud a voice said, this is my son, the beloved. With him I am well pleased. Listen to him. When the disciples heard this, they fell to the ground and were overcome by fear. But Jesus came and touched them, saying, get up and do not be afraid. And when they looked up, they saw no one except Jesus himself alone. As they were coming down the mountain, Jesus ordered them, tell no one about the vision until after the Son of Man has been raised from the dead. The Gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. You may be seated. I forgot during the announcement to thank everyone who stepped up on the 12th and just made church happen that day. That was great. And how Tim could just pull those words out of the sky. And thank you also for last week for doing this so we might have worship. Beloved of God, grace and peace to you from God our Father and our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. Amen. Imagine the day And Jesus comes up to Peter and James and John and he says, let's go for a hike. Let's go for a hike. Let's go hike up the mountain. So they're trudging up the mountain. And when they get there, Jesus says, how about if we just take a little time and pray here? How about if we just, you know, kind of take a little time and catch our breath and maybe pray a little bit and just be quiet? Okay. And then in the midst of this, as the disciples are praying, Jesus is transformed to be bright as the sun and dazzling white. And the disciples immediately become afraid. Well, I think I would too. And then we got Peter in here. Now, Peter's the leader, and Peter's got anxiety issues, and Peter wants to kind of change everything, kind of tone down what's happening. So he offers to build little tents for Jesus and Moses and Elijah. That's part of the tradition in the Jewish faith. Peter's trying to bring things under control. Under control of the chaos. In the chaos, though, they're seeing Jesus in a new and a different way. They are seeing and being reminded of Moses, the one who brought leadership, and Elijah the prophet, the law and the prophet. They see all that. And then the cloud descends. Bright cloud descends. And in that cloud is the voice. And they've heard this voice before. It's the voice that spoke at Jesus' baptism. It says, this is my son, my beloved, with whom I am well pleased. And then the voice says, listen to him. Now, they heard that before. They heard that announcement of who Jesus was, but they still are just terrified. But it all changes when Jesus comes and touches them. And all everything just calms down. And they head back down the mountain. And I just can't imagine them keeping their mouths shut until after the resurrection. That would be the most difficult thing asked of anybody, I think. They experienced Jesus. Do we experience Jesus? I have never seen Jesus in that way. As bright as the sun, as dazzling the clothes. I've never seen Jesus that way. But you know, I have seen Jesus in the giggle of a little child. The innocence of the little child and the things that they say. Sometimes they say amazing things about God and the world and people. I've seen Jesus in the answering of prayers. And every prayer is answered. Just got to remember that we're not always in control of the answer. I have seen Jesus in the fun that we have with family and friends, the joy that is celebrating. I've seen Jesus. I've seen Jesus in the wonder of the snowfall. Oftentimes, like Tracy has said, we sit here and we live in a snow globe. And to watch that beauty from the window inside coming down. I see Jesus. And I know that you see Jesus too. But sometimes I think we forget how Jesus shows himself to us. How God comes to us in many and various ways. So they had that experience, that amazing experience. But there's a part of what the voice of God says in here that they've not heard before. And the voice says, listen to him.
Listen to him.
I want us to talk about what it is we hear when we sit quietly and listen. If we sit quietly and listen, we will hear the Spirit of God as she is stirring, whispering in our ears, "You have been wonderfully created in the likeness and image of God. You have been formed to be who you are. You have been formed in a way that brings honor to God. Male, female, colored, white, gay, straight, and so on. God has wonderfully created you in that way. And if we listen, we will hear the voice that says, you are my beloved. You are my beloved. In Isaiah 43, which is my absolute favorite passage in Scripture, the first 2.5 verses, in there, the voice of God is saying, I've created you in my image. I have formed you to be who you are. I know you, and I call you by name. Now, one of the amazing parts of that is when it says, I know you. The understanding in the Old Testament that if you knew somebody, you knew everything about them. You knew their strengths, their weaknesses. You knew those things that they didn't want anybody else to know. Those little secrets about things. But God says, I know you. God knows you in that way. And then God says, and you are mine. We hear, if we will listen, the voice of God saying, no matter who you are mine. You are a child of God. If we will but listen, if we will but listen, we will hear. Now, there is a reason behind when God created us, we only got one mouth and two ears. And we all know why that is, right? Use one less than the other. But we got it turned around, don't we? We like to use the one and let the two just rest. Something that is so hard for us is to be quiet. Oh, that's hard. That is hard. Even when you're sitting with God, it's hard to be quiet because we think we got to be talking all the time. We got to be praying. We got to do something all the time. It's even hard to be quiet with God. Do you ever find yourself just chattering away? Trying to remember one more thing to say. If we are but willing to take some time, a little time each day, and just be quiet. Maybe it's as you are driving someplace, turn off the radio and just listen. Maybe it might mean that you're going to have to turn off your phone and listen. Or walk away from the computer screen and listen. Or probably even turn off the TV and listen. For all of those things are distractions that keep us from hearing God. Because we don't like to be quiet. We like noise. We like noise around us. God says in this command, as he declares who Jesus is, he says to listen to him. Listen. Zip the lip and open the ears. I often will pray, you know, Lord, give me ears in my heart that I might hear. Give me ears to hear and eyes to see. I've never asked that my lips be zipped, though. So maybe I should add that. If we will but listen. If we will but listen, we will hear God say, I have created you. I have formed you to be who you are. I know you, and I still say you are mine. Okay, here's the assignment for the week. And it may be one of the more difficult assignments that you've been given in the last 5 years. This one is, you gotta be quiet. You got to be quiet. Find a place, a way to just be quiet and listen. Find a way to do that. It requires some discipline because we love our phones. We just love hanging, and we just feel like we can't live without it being on in front of us. This is going to require discipline. This assignment's going to be a tough one. And I will promise you from the depths of my heart, that if you will take that time to be quiet, and I'm not talking about just one day, if you make that a practice in your life, you will hear. You will truly hear the voice of God. You will truly experience that greatness. You will hear the voice that says, I've created you. I have formed you. I know you. And you're still mine. Amen. Continue with our hymn of the day.
Thank you.
I invite you to stand as you're able as we continue with the prayers of the people. Let us pray for the whole people of God in Christ Jesus, for all people according to their needs. Embolden your church as it witnesses to the majesty and mercy of your Son. Move us to share our stories of your faithfulness and forgiveness. May our lives proclaim your greatness. Lord, in your mercy, dwell with your whole creation, from the tallest mountain peak to the deepest valley. Bless the work of conservation organizations and protect vital habitats. Support the work of disaster relief agencies around the world, especially those working in Turkey and Syria. Lord, in your mercy, give shelter to those lacking safe homes. Spur our communities to work for fair housing for all. Protect our neighbors whose dwellings do not keep out dangerous cold or heat. Accompany with your touch those who are homebound, sick, or isolated, especially Carolyn and Luke and Ellen and Kelly and Rich, Mike, Ken, Megan, Gabe, Jan, Teresa, Monica, Fritzy, Harvey, Eddie, Rika, Ruth, Eric, Ken, Lacey, Phyllis, Scott, Lori, Laura, Stu, Marlis, and those we name in our hearts. Continue, O Lord, to comfort all who grieve. Lord, in your mercy, make us eager to receive your word in Scripture. Help us recognize Jesus' voice in the needs of our neighbors. Make us confident to follow the way of the cross. Lord, in your mercy, God of all, hear the prayers we offer to you now, both spoken and silently. We give you thanks, Almighty God, that you hear our prayers and you answer. Thank you for the many who have been, that have been answered. Thank you that you've heard those and help us to be patient in seeking the answers. Lord, in your mercy, for into your hands, O gracious God, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you all. Let's share that peace with one another.
Peace. God's peace. Damn, God's peace to you. Great. God's peace. Glory, God's peace. God's peace. God's peace. God's peace. God's peace.
We continue now with our tithes and our offerings. Thank you. I invite you to stand as you're able as we continue with our offering prayer. And together we pray. Blessed are you, O God, maker of all things. Through your goodness, you have blessed us with these gifts, ourselves, our time, and our possessions. Use us and what we have gathered in feeding the world with your love, through the one who gave himself for us, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. As the words of institution are said, I invite those who are at home to lift up your gifts. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you." Again, after supper, he took the cup, he gave thanks, and he gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in the remembrance of me." Together we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. This is the meal of Christ for the people of Christ. You are invited. You may be seated.
Beautiful Savior.
I invite you to stand for our communion blessing. In the name of the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. And together we pray. God of abundance, with this bread of life and cup of salvation, you have united us with Christ, making us one with all your people. Now send us forth in the power of your Spirit, that we may proclaim your redeeming love to the world and continue forever in the risen life of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Yeah, I invite you to help us fill those birthday bags. You know, there is an order to it. Just try to figure it out. Yeah, you can. I invite you then to open your hearts to receive God's blessing. And now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord's face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord look upon you with favor and grant you peace in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our sending hymn.